Hello, my name is Joel, also known by the name Biscuit. And today is August 24, 2012. And I'm sorry that for many months very little programming has happened on my channel. But one of the reasons to the shortage of those programming videos is that I have been learning new technologies. One of these new technologies that I have been learning to use is called Arduino. Arduino is an open source electronics prototyping platform, as is written here. With a board like Arduino, you can do many things that you cannot simply do with a PC. And I was thinking, to illustrate programming on an Arduino, I will show for an example how to dump the contents of a ROM chip, such as the BIOS of a PC, from an old 386. For that purpose, I have here just the right thing, an old 386 motherboard. And you can see the BIOS here. So first I need to remove the BIOS chip from the motherboard. Which didn't take much time. If I peel the label off, you can see a crystal window through which the actual microchip can be seen. That is because it's an EEPROM, which can be reprogrammed by exposing the window to ultraviolet light, which erases the PROM contents. Now, to utilize the time efficiently, I will do some multitasking and proceed to write the actual program while I am also assembling the ROM reader, thanks to time travel abilities granted by video editing tools. In the bottom right corner, I just finished writing the makefile for this project. It will remain unchanged for the rest of the video. Each pin of the ROM chip accepts only one bit of the relevant data. Therefore, the 18-bit ROM address is sent as 18 distinct bits, each to their distinct pin. In the same way, the 8-bit ROM data is read as 8 distinct bits, each from the distinct pin. I put a 3-color LED into my device just for fun. So So now is the time to test it. First the compiling, which will take some time. In the meantime, I am powering up the Arduino by connecting the USB wire to it. Then uploading the program. And finally, the testing. I'm using a terminal program, Minicom, to connect to the Arduino using the USB serial link. If all goes well, and it did, my program will be talking with Minicom. Hooray, it works! But dealing with the hex dump is hardly the optimal way to go. Many serial communication programs are capable of transferring files directly through a protocol called ZMODEM. Next, I will create the ZMODEM sender and add it to my ROM dumping program on the Arduino. If you have more difficulty following it than I have pronouncing words that end in a glossive, I suggest you download the ZMODEM specification from Omen Technology and read it to better understand the concepts handled in this code. ZMODEM was highly popular in the later age of BBS communication before the internet was commonplace. It was implemented in most terminal programs such as Telex or Telemate. ZMODEM was a competitor to Kermit, named after the Muppet, and a successor to YMODEM, which was a successor to XMODEM, all popular back in their age, for file downloads and uploads. The key features of ZMODEM file transmission included resumability, CRC checks for reliability, low overhead for better utilization of the bandwidth, and a method for automatically starting the transfer. It was a packet-based protocol with a sliding window. I may be the first person in the world to write the ZMODEM implementation in the newest standard of C++, C++11. A lot of C++11 lambda functions were used in this code. You recognize them from the auto keyword. Though it may be uncalled for, I did so in order to reduce the size of the class header file, in which all the class methods would have to be introduced, even if they are purely internal. Apparently, there is no performance backlash to doing it this way. Make it so. In this receiver code, I used the coroutine technique again. It occurs in many of my videos. It works because in C and C++, the case labels in a switch case structure are just labels, They can be placed anywhere, even inside the if and for constructions that occur inside the switch case. Basically, the switch just works like a goto, and the cases are labels. Here, this fascinating feature of the language is utilized to provide a mechanism where the function execution can be resumed on the next invocation right after the previous return statement. Alright, done again. Compiling now. Alright, now if all went right, and it did, you should see the file transfer begin immediately when I hit the right button. The transfer speed seems to be about 6 kilobytes in a second. Now, 6 kilobytes in a second is not as fast as it could go in the 115-200 kilobaud serial link. There is a performance bottleneck in my ZMODEM implementation, and I will quickly fix that now. By the way, computer BIOS ROMs are not the only thing that you can dump with this device. The actual reason why I created this thing was to dump the ROM from a Famicom game cartridge that I have. I succeeded. I did that a few weeks after publishing the video in which I showcased the games on that cartridge. I will not show that in this video though. There. Time to test it again. The download speed should now be much higher than 6 kilobytes in a second. Thank you. Now, what I did here was just a rudimentary implementation that works mostly fine when the serial line is mostly errorless. However, in making a robust ZMODEM sender that works even if the transmission line is not exactly errorless, many small changes will have to be implemented. One of the most important ones is to vary the window size depending on the transfer conditions. But I'm also taking the opportunity to make this code more portable in the process. Next up, adding CRC32 support for even more robust file transfers. I am also adding a feature which allows the recipient to verify whether they already have the right file and to skip the download if they already have it. Now remember when I added the 3-color LED in the beginning? The classic beginner project for an Arduino programmer is to blink a LED. An example project without a LED blinker is not a real example project, so as part of mandatory testing protocol I will now add a LED blinker to the project. There are two common mistakes that people often make when they try to program RGB LEDs. One is in assuming that when you feed equal current to the red, green and blue LED, you get white light. No you don't. The human eye is not very sensitive to blue and red light, so to compensate those LEDs are made very bright. When you shine all of those at full power, you get a purple light, not a white one. In order to get the white light, you will have to put a much lower current to the red LED than to the green one, and even lower to the blue one. And the second mistake is in assuming that linear increase in current makes linear increase in brightness perception. It does not. The actual relationship is logarithmic. To compensate, you will have to do a gamma calculation, which is simply an exponentiation. I did both fixes in this code. Thanks for watching, see you next time!